Bible. See, you hear Bible verses coming out of my mouth. You hear the words of the Bible. And most of you won't even read the Bible because your Pope has taught you, your Catholic priest has taught you not to read the Bible. Oh, woe to you. Because you have chosen to believe a lie rather than to believe the truth.
Yeah. You see, it's already starting.
You see, you need to be like Paul. Paul commended the Berean church in the book of Acts. He commended the Berean church because they went home and searched the scriptures. They searched the scriptures to see if what Paul was saying was true. You won't even search the scriptures to see if what the Pope says is true. You won't even search the scriptures to see if what your priest tells you is true. Your Bible probably has enough dust on it that you could write hell and damnation on it.
Looking at is a man-centered religion. Now I want you to listen to them, and then I will give you the discernment, the commentary, that you might understand what is going on. This is pure religion. Man's purpose to reach God with all of its decoration, its clothing, its religious form, him folding his hand there, bowing down, and kissing the Bible. Jesus Christ. Hope is in Christ. Christ alone. He is not Christ. He's a man. A fallen man. And you're worshiping him as he sits on his throne with his funny hat. No place in the Bible does it say you are supposed to do this. Show me one example. Just one. Can you discern this? God, can you judge this and examine this?
Brothers and sisters in Christ.
Oh, now listen.
Peace be with you.
It's wicked.
This
evil.
Is the first words of the risen Lord and his disciples. I greet all of you with the joy of this Easter season. Before all else, I thank God for the blessing of being in your midst. I am particularly grateful to Archbishop Ward for his kind words of welcome. Our mass today brings the Church in the United States back to its roots in Irby, Maryland, and commemorates bicentennial of the first chapter of this remarkable growth. The division by my predecessor.
No lie. Do you see death on you?
The decision of my predecessor.
Does anybody have any discernment?
Of the original diocese.
No, no, you're lying.
And the establishment of the diocese.
Joy.
In bringing together widely different immigrant groups within the unity of the Catholic faith.
How long, O man, will you turn my glory into shame? How long will you love delusions and seek false gods? Know that the Lord.
Can you repeat what he says? Can you read off of what he says?
The Catholic community's country has come to appreciate even more fully the importance of each individual group offering its own particular gifts to the whole. The Church in the United States is now called to look to the future, firmly grounded in the faith passed on by previous generations and ready to meet new challenges. Challenges no less demanding than in the exercise of my ministry of successor of Peter, I have come to America to confirm.
Stand with the blood of the martyr.
He's
lied unto you, and he's going to take you straight to hell, folks. You need to wake up. Wake up, because the repentance unto men will not stand in the judgment of God. Repentance unto a pope will not stand in the judgment of God. Hey, you are going to die in your sin and go to hell. You're going to be deceived. In Matthew, Jesus said, many shall come unto me and say, have we not prophesied in thy name? And cast out devils in thy name? And done many wonderful works in thy name? And he's going to confess unto them, depart from me, ye that work iniquity. You're a worker of iniquity. You're a blasphemer of the Holy Ghost, the work of the Holy Ghost. You people, you are on the slab. The devil is about to slay you. That old serpent will turn on you. You are wicked to follow after the beast. Look at his priesthood. Pedophiles, drunkards, whoremongers. They hate God. They defy the word of God. Just like your pope. He sits in the seat of the Most High God. That's what the devil wanted to do. The devil wanted to sit in the seat of the Most High God, and he was cast into hell. He was cast into hell. And now he's on this earth. He was cast from heaven. Now he's on the earth. And the devil has set up his throne. He set up a throne of worship. And that throne of worship is in the Vatican. The Vatican. And you are on your way to hell, folks, because you lift up worship unto the Vatican. You lift up worship unto the little horn in Daniel. You're of the beast. You're of the beast. You're of those that are standing that's going to come up to the bridle of the horse. You're going to fill the valley with your blood because you stand against Jesus Christ. You stand against the Holy One of Israel. You stand against the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You have lifted up a dead woman. You pray unto a dead woman, and you put the Christ that has victory over death and hell. You have put him on the cross, and you're a mass murderer. You think you can sin, and you can murder Jesus Christ anytime at your own convenience to cover your sin? Hey, God said that he died once for you, and once for all. You cannot be a mass murderer. You are a mass murderer, cannibal, blood-drinking sucker that's going to go to hell. You need to repent of your evil. You need to repent of your abominations before God. God is not pleased when you're abominable. A idolatrous religion that follows after the beast. Look at the lies. Look at the lies. You know they are lies. That's why you stand here looking for something greater than the doctrines of your religion. You're looking for a man to lead you, and he'll lead you. He'll lead you right into the pit because he's blinded. He doesn't see the light of God. He doesn't know Jesus Christ. And he's going to lead you into the pit of hell because the blind leadeth the blind, and they both shall fall into the ditch. You're on your way to hell, folks. Wake up. Jesus said, I am the way. He didn't say Mary was the way. He didn't say saints were the way. He didn't say the Pope was the way. He didn't say religion was the way. He didn't say baptism was the way. He didn't say good works were the way. Jesus said, I am the way. He said, I'm the truth. He didn't say the Pope was the truth. He didn't say your religion was the truth. He said that he is the way. He is the truth. He is life. Your Pope's about dead. He's about physically dead, and he's spiritually dead. You follow after a beast that has only a life for a short time, and now he's raising up his head because he knows that he's going to be cast.